Good evening. I am Daksh. I'm the founder of Blood World magazine. We work on the focus of finding teenagers who are doing inspiring work in life and sharing their work with other teens. So the focus of our work is simply teens inspiring teens. Till date, we have showcased and taken stories of more than 300 teenagers to a lot more teenagers across 5,000 schools across South Asia. And from time to time, we try to create industry white papers on K-12 sector, which is typically schools. And these white papers are focused on finding what all innovative or new is happening in schools. We all right now are experiencing something for the first time in our life, which is a lockdown. And we never expected it and never wanted it rather. But since it has happened, a lot of innovation has started happening in schools. The reason behind doing this activity is very simple. Every section of the society is supposed to contribute to society with its own capabilities, experiences, understandings, and perceptions. As farmers are taking care of our food, doctors are taking care of our health, and your retailer is taking care of your supply chain, every educationist now has one more duty added to what you were supposed to do. The first one was delivering knowledge. Now you're supposed to even create the knowledge that the world would need in the coming times. Because we all don't know what kind of a school would we actually see once this lockdown comes to an end. Just to give you an idea, this today is the 40th session of these web talks. Till now, in the last 39 sessions, we have talked to more than 400 school leaders from 60 plus geographies from across the world. Every day we are taking their ideas and sharing some of the best ideas on our different social media. And just yesterday, the first white paper out of this series was published in the magazine that will reach to all of you as well. It has somewhere around 99 ideas that were shared by some of the amazing minds from all across the world. And you can also implement those ideas within your schools. So first and foremost, before I actually do a detailed introduction of what kind of things we've got and what we want from you, welcome all of you to the Blood World Web Talks 40th session. And today, in the next 30 to 40 minutes, we'll try to know your perception, your opinion, understanding, or your innovation that you have done in your school during this lockdown to continue learning. And what do you think would change in the school post this lockdown? Because just to give you an idea, after talking to these many educationists, we know one thing for sure. The idea of a school or the concept of a school, the way we know it, has already been obliterated. It does not exist anymore. Simply because a school was supposed to be an organization that run on a financial model where small number of people handled a lot of people. But now this cannot be done because there has to be a lot of social distancing. We worked on the concept of bringing the society together, but now we have to teach them social distancing. We worked on the concept of one person teaching many people. But since the lockdown began, all of us here within the screen have acted very well like amazing politicians and told our kids to come on the screen, which we always, had bad things to say about. But now the whole school is in a screen and we are promoting them to use it for the 6 to 7 hours in every day. So now kids are accustomed to one-on-one learning, because when it's online, it's one-on-one. And when it's offline and in a class, it's one-to-many. So once the school reopens, the characteristics, the persona of the student that you had and the teacher that you have will change. And the class dynamics will also change. So at the same time, it's a difficult scenario. And at the same time, it's a very exciting scenario, because this is the time when actual innovation will happen and education will see a completely new and rejuvenated system. So let's see what all you have got to share with us before I ask you. Just to give you some reference of the kind of ideas that we have got till now, there's a very small village called Padua in West Bengal. They don't have internet, but one of the schools there is doing something amazing. They ask their students to create a custom dictionary at home in which they have to add 5 new words every day and bring that dictionary back to school once the school reopens. There's one school in Agra that has asked students to do a daily news report of their surroundings. There is one school in Nepal that has started a class called Problem Solving Engineering. that go and find what your the problems that your mom faces in the kitchen and give it an engineering solution. And kids are doing amazing work with that. There is one school in Gujarat, I think a Swaminarayan Trust run school. Since the lockdown began, they were not able to send back their hostlers. And since that time, they are right now housing 50 hostlers within their vicinity. And we are trying to prepare an observation paper on what do they do with these kids and how do they keep them engaged for such a long time and under such a duressful situation. So I think this would give you an idea of what we are looking at. So I hope you enjoy the next 20, 30 minutes. Once again, welcome to the Love World Web Talks 40th session. Let's now first hear it from Pooja ma'am. Pooja ma'am, over to you for the 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio and the next 2 minutes are yours.
Hello everyone. My name is Pooja Sharma and I'm the principal of Sri Atmiya Shishu Vidya Mandir School, Rajkot, Gujarat. Definitely, this unprecedented situation of COVID-19, the pandemic which has engulfed the whole country and all the people's minds and hearts, is we cannot expect that thing. We have never expected that thing to happen. We have not ever experienced that, and we hope that the coming generation should not experience such kind of a situation. Now, talking about as a leader of one of the schools is a big task, because the apprehensions of the students, the apprehensions of the teachers and apprehensions of the parents is too much, and the burden is on definitely the principal most of the times, because the management takes the back seat at this situation and the principal is to just be on the front page of the school. So yes, we have tried a lot of things in order to make this teaching learning process go on. We face lots of constraints. And definitely the part, parents also do have a lot of constraints. The first, the foremost thing which you were also talking about, that why we felt that screen was not at all good for the children most of the times, and that's what we used to say, don't give mobile phones, let not your children use the mobile phones, keep a check on the mobile phones. And now we are only the ones who are telling the parents, no, your child need to sit in front of the mobile phone or the laptop and have to attend these sessions. So it's, yeah, definitely a contradictory behavior on the parts of the education institutions. But on the positive side, if we see, yes, we are making the children realize that yes, technology also has a very positive impact in your lives. When needed, it is there for you. So we have also in school, like the one thing which you said, even I have started in my groups, we like what we did, we made WhatsApp groups of all the classes separately. The teachers, the subject teachers were added, and even I was added in those groups. And then starting what we did, we sent the videos and we sent the a newspaper column in that group every day. And we asked the parents to get one word for lower sections 1 to 5, just get one word from there and ask your child to get the meaning from the dictionary. In that manner, children will learn to use the dictionary also. Because nowadays children never use dictionaries. They use the mobile dictionaries most of the times. So now in this manner, they will use the dictionary and get the word and they can use it and how to use in their language, that one thing which we did, definitely. Secondly, what we tried off, we had the first Zoom sessions. Then we started off with the Google Meets, because lots of then the complaints from the side of the parents were there regarding the misuse of the Zoom. So we had the meetings, those.
Ma'am, the time was over. We'll again try to come back to you. You're muted, not an issue. We'll try to come back if the time allows us. Thank you so much for sharing that. I think this newspaper column to each student on a WhatsApp group and then trying to build a vocabulary around that is something interesting to know. And thank you so much for sharing your thoughts. Let's now hear it from Sarika, ma'am. Sarika, ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you, Balbal Laksa. I am Sarika Sharma, Principal, Dune Public School, Bhuj. And see, what I feel is real world and the real change comes when there is a deep crisis. So it is very important for all of us. It has been done in the past after World War II, and in when it was every 100 year we face all those calamities, and school come up and teachers are the new warriors nowadays. They are not even warriors. They are real heroes. Because you know the infrastructure of the schools, especially in the remote locations. I am in Bhuj, so I know the conditions very well. Second important thing, how we have done utilize this time. This is a very important time. Today is the 60th day when our school has been closed. So what we have done is, we have done a continuous CPD programs for our teachers. High level of training has been done for all the teachers on board, so that now they are the 21st century teaching skills they have. We have spent little more amount what we were spending earlier on the teachers training, and we have made them techno savvy, because the school is old one and you know the teacher scenario everywhere. And not even this, we have taken some government schools on board, okay, and we have even trained those teachers along with our own teachers, nearby schools, government schools, so that, you know, everybody can be trained, because it's not about only one school, it's about country, it's about globalization. Every child needs good education. We have to collaborate. Every school has to collaborate. So we have taken two schools and we have trained the teachers of those two schools on our expenditure. And deep training has been given in 50 days along with students. The classes has been going on through via, you know, Microsoft and through Zoom and all those things. And second very important thing which I feel as a leader is, when the school will reopen, when we are going to welcome our students, empathy needs to be a very important thing, a very important skill which has to be developed, because many of my own students have lost lives in their own families. They have seen a crucial pandemic crisis, and some of them, because it's a business class community, so they have been a lot of lockdown situations they have seen. So empathy as well as patience, these two skills have to be developed, and vocational skill based courses started online. So these are the things which we have done during lockdown. One hand has already been raised. So the post thing is that the teachers has to be, you know, they has to be given a lot of motivation. They have to be given a lot of positive attribute, because one teacher connects to 100 students, 160 students, and she passes on everything. So we have done a lot of work on our teachers, and we have tried to collaborate through our teachers to all the stakeholders, whether it is the management, whether it is the trustees, whether it is students, whether it is masis, drivers, cleaners, or parents. Every teacher once in a week try to have a parents meeting and give them a lot of things which parent and student diaries, everything.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. I think again you were muted, then, but we'll try to come back. Thank you so much. I think please share with us the program, training program that you are currently doing for the government schools in collaboration with your school. We would like to showcase what all interesting you're doing with them. Thank you so much. And this is something, again, we all need to understand that as educational institutions, we should build empathy. We should now be actually open to collaborating with institutions which are not very capable enough, and then sharing your capabilities with them. Because now in the coming times, it's going to be a big challenge to actually continue education. Let's now hear it from Dr. Prerna. Ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
Good evening, everyone. And good evening, Mr. Daksh. I think you have spoken most of the points and taken the words from our mouth, because every school is following their own best practices. And am I audible to everyone? Yes, okay. So I really second the points of Sarika ma'am and Pooja ma'am. Besides that, I'll cut short. First of all, I'll give my introduction. I'm Dr. Prerna Mitra, Principal Army Public School, Lucknow. And I'm in this profession for past 29 years. And I have seen, you know, so many things, so many changes. I think this is first time ever that everyone is facing this pandemic. And the unique thing which I am practicing with my students, as everyone is doing, they are having the online teaching, they are doing online trainings for the teachers. The first thing that I wanted my students to know is how to manage crisis. That is, crisis management is very important because this is the need of the hour. Where technology has taken the front seat, as well as health and also social distancing. We have taught the students that these three words are very important for them along with this coronavirus. So along with that, according to the age group, while the online teaching is on, we have made sure that every student, according to the age, they pursue their hobby at home since they are spending most of their time with their parents. So for primary students, basically, we have given them tasks that at least once in a week, they will prepare any one object or any one thing best out of the waste. So how to make something new, something creative, best out of the waste. Now for junior wing, basically, they have to do gardening and they have to pursue other things related to like weather forecast. They will note down the weather maximum and minimum temperature every day from the, maybe from the technology, from the newspaper, though they are not allowed to touch newspaper, but still, you know, they have to be sensitized about their surroundings and also the general awareness. They will note down the points. And for the senior wing, that is how they are imbibing values by knowing the expenditures at home. That is, they will be the budget managers. So this is the task, you know, which we are trying to inculcate in the students during this time of online teaching. Vis-a-vis with the academics, children are also learning these activities. And in the evening time, we are also having all activity and co-curricular activities with the students. We have around 10 activity classes. Normally, we were having it. Along with that, the teachers, they are also imparting online teaching to these students during the evening time. Like we are having martial arts training, we are having art, craft, music. So everything is going hand in hand along with the academics. So that's all from my side. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I think senior students to become budget managers at home is something interesting. And there is a very nice concept that one of the schools in, I think, Darjeeling or Northeast, in some Northeastern state, that's the Springdale Institute. They're doing something very interesting. They have coined a concept called time balance sheet.
Yes.
They've asked students to create a time balance sheet every evening and consider time that they have every day like money in their pocket.
Yes.
And they have developed this concept very well. And we'll be sharing an observation paper around this so that a lot of people can experiment this within their schools.
Yes.
This gives them a very good understanding of time management.
Wonderful.
To create a balance sheet of time. And this is something interesting and they're right now, you know, working on it. Thank you so much, Prerna ma'am. Let's now hear it from Shweta ma'am. Shweta ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
Hi. I'm Shweta Pandya. I'm principal of Suraj International School, Junagadh. Most of you have covered almost all the points. I don't have to say many things. But yes, after the school gets reopened, what all we have to do? I'll come to the point now, straight away. What all we have to do is, like, we need to teach them when these kind of situations they come across, what all they have to do, they have to face it. So basically we have to develop that skill in them. They don't have right now, what happened, that they are not ready to accept the situation. In Junagadh, it's for us, of course, the technology is not that good. I mean, we cannot reach to each and every students of ours since they are located in some other area where the internet connectivity is not so good. So, but yes, we have started Google Meet. We do teach them. We have almost started our curriculum online. We are getting a good response indeed. But apart from that, we also teach them that do help household things. We have organized through the Facebook or social media marketing. We are organizing the essay competitions, drawing competition. Recently, we have conducted, wherein we have got a good results also. We will be rewarding them soon. So, see, somehow we need to engage them. And the creativity should not go from them. So and very important thing, the thing is like they must otherwise see, this is such a long period, they'll forget. I mean, we need to go to school. There's something like study also. So obviously we need to remind them every now and then. So we do give them a homework. PDF worksheets are going every day from our end. Sorry, I was getting a call. I just declined it. And after the school gets reopen, first thing we have to install in them, whatever the situation comes up, you need to be ready. So this should be our prime focus. It's been not taught till now in the school. But yes, now we need to be ready for that, because now if you consider last year, we never thought that such kind of situation will come. We never thought. So of course we have to, when the kids will come to the school, they will all be aware of the technology. They will all be aware of the technology. So that's the best part, which we'll be seeing in them. Secondly, social distancing, as ma'am said, that also we can do. And we can teach them and many more things like that. Okay, I'm done.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Let's now hear it from Mrs. Vinay Sharma. Ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes. You can unmute your audio.
First of all, very good evening to all the participants. And my heartly thanks to Mr. Daksh to give me the opportunity to include in this very healthy session, which we are interacting on the same topic, because nowadays we all are under the same roof, under the same sky. And a few things which I would like to share, as Mrs. Sarika, Mrs. Pooja and Mrs. Prerna, they all shared. I would like to say that although Vrindavan is not a very a big city, we belong to Vrindavan, and the name of my school is Kanamakhan Public School. And here I'm working with this school from last 18 years. It's a senior secondary school affiliated to CBSE. So nowadays, we also try to learn so many new things, all our team, because this is the very first time we saw such kind of circumstances around us. So we are running Google Classrooms, that app we are using for our children. Along with that, we have made WhatsApp group also for the parents. We are sending the content, and it's going on in very interactive way. Students are also sending after completing the task which is assigned to them through that. And we open the parents forum for 1 hour, and we interact their problems. They send to us their queries and confusions or problems, or their suggestions also, which we welcome. And every head of the particular wing, they attend them for 1 hour in the evening. Time is given to all the parents. So it's going on well. Although we discuss with the teachers, and we try that we should not give a stressful task to the students. They should be engaged from our side, and by the time in the engaging way, they should learn something also. Up to the primary classes, the focus is on they should get fruitful activities. So many activities we are sending. And to the senior children, as in 10th class, in 12th class, 11th, 9th, we are giving them content as well, which should be helpful for them for the preparation of their coming exams. So in different parts, we are trying to manage with the different focuses. And we are getting continuously the queries and problems or suggestions from the parents also. And the post-lockdown things, which was asked by me that I should give some suggestions for that. So a few things I would like to share. Although it's very new for all of us to think about this topic, but still few points are in my mind which I would like to express here. The very first thing which I would like to focus with my students, that they should be made more sensitized towards the nature and environment, which is the demand of the time which we are seeing here. Secondly, they should give spatial education regarding the good habits related to their hygiene, how to manage that. Then moral values, the helping nature to each other, not becoming selfishness, they should forget now, as they are seeing around that people are helping to each other. And to get prepared and ready to face any unusual circumstances, as this pandemic which we are seeing here. So how, like as Madam said, that crisis management. So this kind of skills they should learn for future, for facing any kind of challenges. And the very important thing which I feel that instead of just taking the tests and exams continuously, which we have to take as per the CBSE guidelines also, instead of that, we should spend more time in capacity and skill building of our students. Like decreasing the tests and exams and giving more time on such kind of activities which can prepare the children, which can prepare the student for their practical lives. Which they should, as you said, like budget management, they should learn. They should know how to make their time balance sheet or crisis management. And some practical things we should now decrease. So that kind of strategies we are planning, that as board has also asked to us that we should plan something for continuing that potential. Keeping this thing in mind, we're sending like all activities which we used to do in the school. We are here, all those activities should carry on the students at their home also, in the form of sports or the dance classes or like craft classes or some competitions also I organized in between, like on the last Mother's Day, they made very good cards and they sent to us on WhatsApp also, on Google Classroom also they sent to us, they submitted to us. And very beautiful creativity came out. And for Go Corona, they made the posters and they sent to us. And very nice. Like, if children are getting nowadays, they are getting more time. And they are creating, they are showing their talent. I think my time is over. Okay. Thank you so much for sharing your part of this event.
I think skill development has actually taken the front seat right now, and academics have taken a back seat for some time. And every educationist had a utopian dream that we'll teach students value education, and a school was absolutely not able to do that. And I think this is a sweet spot that everybody has got with the right teachers for teaching value education. Parents are the best teachers for that, and this is the right time to deliver that. So before this talk comes to an end, I would like to leave all of you some thought. These are some ideas I want to share with you, which you can, you know, keep thinking on, and then we can meet again. This time, right now, the whole world has actually converted into a big educational laboratory. We have all the children in amazing situations and controlled atmospheres, and you can experiment a lot of things with them. And I suppose, and I want, and I wish that every single educationist at this time should focus on experimenting any and every idea that you ever had in life that you think is scalable and usable and has a utility for kids. And try building a habit of creating an observation paper every day on what do you think is happening in the education sector. And whatever ideas you get, please share it with us. We are taking some of the best observation papers and publishing them as well. Just to make this activity even exciting for schools, we are trying to find out the most creative school in South Asia. And there is absolutely no fees to participate in it. School leaders, your parents, your teachers, your students, anybody can participate. And whatever creative you're doing during this time, you, your school, your students, you can share it with us. There is a cash prize to be won. The reason why we're giving a cash prize so that any small little innovation at least reaches us, because that small innovation would create a big change in the coming times. And every institution should right now put everything aside and focus on innovation only, because this is the time when you have a lot of free time and which can be utilized in this direction. All of us right now are using a lot of education technology platforms. Just to share an observation that we've got after talking to so many people is that most of these edtech products or edtech platforms are not solving education problems. They are solving communication problems. So education problems still remain at your hand to be solved. So keep thinking on those lines. The whole world saw a big shift in the commercial market when the world globalized. Before that, it was a seller's market. Jo brand chahti thi, wahi kharidna hota tha. And when globalization happened, it became a buyer's market. That buyer decided what he wanted and the brands created it. And this is the time for K-12 sector when it has turned from a school's ecosystem to a learner's ecosystem. You'll have to focus curriculum, your teaching approach, your content, everything on the student, because once a student is online, he decides whether he wants to listen to you or not. And with 30% school capacity, as the MHRD has told, we cannot have all the students together come back to the school. So it is going to be blended learning in the future. So let's focus more on actually creating content or teaching that keeps students interested, engaged, and excited. This is something that's difficult, but this is the skill that a teacher will need in the coming times. And we think there are two skills which are super critical right now, which have to be taught to every single student. The biggest problem with these two skills is you can teach them, but you cannot evaluate them. The first such skill is creativity. Creativity not in the sense of just colors and paintings, creativity in the sense of critical thinking, perceptive analysis, observation, and actually teaching a kid how to think. And second and most important, we have all right now forced or told kids to be on the screen for 6 to 8 hours and open the world of internet to them. And there is nobody to police them or monitor them because nobody can. So this is the time that you need to actually decipher them, the actual word meaning of the word knowledge. Knowledge comes from two words, knowing and the second ledge. Ledge is where you stand. So knowing your ledge, you'll have to teach them wisdom, because only and only their own wisdom can keep them safe in the online world. How is this going to happen? How are we going to teach it? We don't know. Let's find out. Let's think on things, create observation papers, share what all amazing and great you are doing right now within your school, because we are facing different scenarios. In every call, we try to bring people from the complete spectrum of schools so that there's a very varied discussion. There are schools with no internet. There are schools with super amazing technology being there. So try to experiment within your ecosystem so that you can give amazing innovations. And I hope all this lockdown turns out to be a very rejuvenating and a new kind of an experience for all of you with a lot of positive connotation. So I hope you enjoyed the last 20, 30 minutes. If you did, and if you want to attend the future sessions, you can open your mic and say a big yes. If by chance you got anything, our team will be connected with you. You can share that on WhatsApp and we'll take your opinion on that. Thank you so much for people for being here with us.
We really enjoyed, Mr. Daksh. Thank you so much. Yes, a big yes for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Daksh.